अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम बैक टू योर ए टू क्लास इकोनॉमिक्स आफ्टर ई के। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू कंग्रेचुलेट द स्टूडेंट्स अबाउट देयर रिजल्ट्स। दोज हु हैव अचीव्ड गुड रिजल्ट्स, दे कैन परफॉर्म इवन बेटर इन देयर ए टू सिलेबस, एंड दोज हु आर स्ट्रगलिंग हार्ड दे हैव टू वर्क फर्दर इन ऑर्डर टू इम्प्रूव देयर ग्रेड्स। Anyhow, stay blessed. In A2, we are following our A2 syllabus right now. Before it, we were talking about production function and producer behavior, and we discussed some of the things, how producer will be using the inputs or the factors of production in order to produce the goods and services. We said production or quantity produced is going to be the function of the factors of production. Like if he is putting in more inputs or factors of production, the producer will be able to produce more quantity of a product. So we also explained the things like short run production function and long run production function. In case of the short run production function, we discussed that at least one factor of production is kept fixed and others are going to be the variable factors. Whereas in long run, we said all the factors of production are going to be variable. Nothing is kept fixed. So in that case, when firm is able to vary all its factors of production, it will be moving into long run time period. And when it is having at least one factor of production fixed, then it is in the short run. We have also explained the things like total physical product, like how total output is produced by all the workers, that is total physical product of the workers. And we also said marginal physical product, the additional output produced by an additional worker. And average product of labor, average physical product, that tells us how per worker output is produced. That shows us the productivity of the workers. When total output is divided by the total number of workers, that gives us the average physical product. That is about the recap of our previous lesson. We are going to discuss the things or explaining the things, law of diminishing returns. The short run production function, we said at least one factor of production is kept fixed. Now this short run production function, actually, that is subject to the diminishing returns. What do we mean by diminishing returns? It means when we are having fixed factor, like capital is fixed, producer is having a machinery or capital that is fixed. Now, one by one, he is going to increase the workers. And he will see how his total output is going to change. First of all, when capital is not saturated by the workers, then total physical product is increasing by increasing rate as number of worker is added. So additional output is also increasing. So the firm is enjoying, that means there are increasing returns in the short run of the variable factor of production. So a time will come when capital is saturated. Now workers are added one by one. So what happens in that case? Although total physical product is increasing, but marginal physical product of every additional worker starts diminishing. The additional output produced by an additional worker, that is going to diminish. This is what, when we are adding variable factor of production into the fixed factor, then a time will come and some of the workers, their productivity, their per unit output, per worker output, that will also be declining. So this law of diminishing return is also given a name, that is called law of variable proportions. Variable proportions, like how proportionately the variable factor of production is going to be changed and how will it change the production as well. So sometimes in our MCQs, then another name of this law of diminishing returns law is given as law of variable proportions. Students are looking for this name, but we are having this name in our MCQs option. So we should be knowing that these are the two names of the same law. So now I'm going to explain with the help of a table and the diagrams how this law can be examined, how this is going to have a diminishing return of the variable factor of production when we are adding a fixed factor into, when we are adding the variable factor of production, how the additional output of the variable factor will be changing. So law of diminishing return states that, it states that how the marginal physical product of variable factor is eventually diminishing when every additional unit of variable factor of production is added into the fixed factor, into the fixed factors of production. Okay, I have used the general statement, the variable factor. Usually we take the variable factor, the labor is the variable factor, and fixed factor is usually the capital. But any factor can be variable. If we are increasing capital into the fixed number of workers, the same law can be held. But usually capital is fixed, whereas variable factor is the labor. So when we are adding variable factor, like one by one, we are increasing the number of workers, how the total output will be changing, or the additional output or marginal physical product of that variable factor will be eventually diminishing. First of all, it will be increasing, marginal physical product will be increasing, but later on a time will come when it starts diminishing. This is the shortest statement of this law, that the variable factor of production will be having the diminishing returns after a certain time when it is continuously added one by one into the fixed factor of production. Anyhow, now I'm going to make a table of this law. Here I'm taking the labor as a variable factor of production, and capital, that is kept fixed. Here I'm taking total physical product of labor, marginal physical product of labor, and average physical product of labor. Okay. Now when we are having capital, 5 units, they are kept fixed. First worker is added, second worker is there, third worker. We're having same units of capital, they are kept fixed. What is the variable factor here now? The labor. We're looking at the labor is changing by 1 unit. Every additional worker is adding to the total output. First worker, when it is added to the fixed capital, total output goes to 100. All right. Now, when second worker is added, so total output goes to 210. How much is that? First worker, when zero worker was there, total output was zero. So marginal product of first worker was 100. Now, another worker is added, second worker is added. How total output has changed? This is my point. So first of all, it goes to 110. All right. So this is the additional output. The additional worker, he added to the total output by 110 units. First worker was producing 100 units by long. Okay. Now the third worker is added. We see the total output goes to 330. How much total output is added? This is 120 now. He is again adding more than the previous worker. Now the fourth worker is added. What happens? Our total output goes to 410. How much is the total physical product has changed by the additional worker? We say there is going to be 80 units are added by this fourth worker. So here diminishing return has started. Now, as we are adding the variable factor, that is labor, into the fixed factor of production, first of all, it was causing the marginal physical product of every additional worker to rise. And now, as we have added the fourth worker into the same fixed capital units, the additional output added by this fourth worker is only 80 units. So from this worker, diminishing return has started. Now the fifth worker is added with the same units of capital. What happens? We have added 480. So he has added only 70 units of output. So from here onward, from the fourth worker, diminishing return has started. So as we see sixth worker into the same fixed capital, so we say 540, so 60 units are added. So when we find the seventh worker, it says 590. So how much is the additional output? 50. So this shows us, as we are increasing the variable factor of production one by one into the fixed factor of production, that is capital, the additional output of the additional worker that will be eventually diminishing. At the start, it is not diminishing. It is having more productivity at the start. Every additional worker was producing more than the previous at the start till the third worker. It is again 104. Okay, now for the fifth worker, it will be 96 now. Now for the sixth worker, it is 90. And for the seventh worker, point something, okay. Now you can see over here what is happening. What is happening? When marginal product is increasing, average product is also increasing. But it is below the marginal. When marginal is 110, average is below the marginal physical product. The additional worker has added 110, but on average productivity has been 105. When marginal physical product is increasing by 120 units, what happens? Average is still lower than the marginal. It is 110. And when marginal starts diminishing, average has also started. Lower than the average physical product. So what law is stating us? Law is stating that when we are adding the variable factor of production, that is labor, into the fixed factor of production, the additional output or marginal physical product of additional worker will be eventually diminishing. In our case, it starts diminishing from the fourth worker. First, it was increasing as we were adding the variable factor of production, and later on it started decreasing. And we also see over here that when marginal product is increasing, average is also increasing, but marginal product is higher than average. And when marginal product starts diminishing, average product also starting to decline, but now marginal is below the average. Now I'm going to draw the diagrams of this law. Then our law of diminishing return will be finished, and I will be giving you a worksheet, a producer behavior. You have to explain the law of diminishing returns and some terms of producer behavior in that worksheet. Okay, now see over here. This is the number of workers. We are taking labor over here. This is total physical product. So you can see, this is total physical product. Okay. Now what will be the shape of marginal and average physical product? Here I am again taking labor, and here it is marginal physical product of labor and average physical product of labor. Okay. Now see, we see over here, marginal product is having a steeper shape than the average physical product. I said, when marginal product is increasing, it is higher than average. When average product is maximum, it is intersected by the marginal product from its top point. And when marginal product is start declining, average is also decreasing, but now the marginal product is going to be lower than average physical product. Okay. If we see what will be the slope of this total physical product, we have to draw a tangent. This is what change in total physical product due to change in worker. So keep it in mind that marginal physical product is going to be the slope of the total physical product or gradient of this total physical product. You can see as we are approaching, it is becoming flatter and flatter. Its slope is diminishing, and here its slope becomes zero. After that, it may happen that we have added eighth worker. Instead of increasing the total output, it may cause decrease in total output. He will be destroying the output. Okay. So when additional worker rather to produce output, he is destroying the output, then marginal physical product of that worker will be negative. Instead of adding, even by diminishing amount, now he started to destroying the output, then marginal physical product will be moving into the negative part. Okay. So what we have concluded over here, when average product of labor is increasing, what happens? Marginal physical product of labor will be higher than the average physical product of labor. That is taking place over here. So when average physical product of labor is maximum, it is at its maximum point, then marginal physical product of labor will be equal to average physical product of labor. Like at this point, when average product has reached to its maximum point, then it is intersected by the marginal physical product. And when average physical product of labor starts declining, then marginal physical product of labor will be lower than average physical product of labor. This is an outcome of this law, that we are having these two shapes of physical products, both marginal physical product and average physical product of labor. So when marginal physical product is increasing, average is also increasing, but marginal will be higher than average. And when average product is at its maximum point, keep it in mind, marginal product start declining before the average product. That is why it is intersecting the average physical product from its maximum point. And when it has intersected, it is steeply declining before the average physical product start to decline. So when average product of labor start declining, it is lower. It is now higher than the marginal physical product. All right. So law of diminishing returns, this is a short-run law of production function, we said when we are having a short-run production function, some factors of production are fixed. So when we are adding the variable factors of production into the fixed factor of production, you can say if we are adding the number of teachers in the same premises and we are not increasing the number of classrooms, then every additional teacher will be producing us less education. This is going to be called a law of diminishing returns in case of our education. Until unless we increase the number of rooms in our building, then we can enjoy the increasing returns. Otherwise, we can say in every production function, when we are having the fixed factor of production, we're not varying them, and we are varying only the variable factor of production, and we are continuously increasing the variable factor one by one. So what happens? It will have the diminishing return after reaching to a certain point. At that point is called, from here, the diminishing return that started from the fourth worker, where additional worker added only 80 units to the total product. Okay. Before that worker, there was increasing return. We can see over here, this is the increasing return. From that worker, it started decreasing return. Okay. So for that variable factor only, not for all the factors of production. So the per worker output will be moving as the marginal product is changing. When marginal is increasing, this is marginal means what? We are having 7 or 8 students in our class, and we are having average marks of that class 80%. So when another student is added to the same class, what happens? If he or she attains more than 80%, that additional student has attained more than 80%, then our average will also be increasing, class average marks will also be increasing. If that additional student has attained less than 80%, so when additional student marks are lower than the class average, then class average will also be declining. Okay, so same is the case when we are adding the variable factor of production into the fixed factor of production. It depends on the marginal physical product, how will it change, and it will be followed by the average physical product as well. Okay, so when we say when marginal product of every additional worker is increasing, average is also increasing. When marginal physical product of additional worker is starting to diminish, then average will also start decreasing. So this is the relationship between marginal physical product and average physical product by using law of diminishing returns in the short run only, not in the long run. And we can also say total physical product is increasing, but at decreasing rate eventually. That's all for today. We have concluded law of diminishing returns. In our next class, we will be doing the long run production function and isoquant, and then isocost line. And we'll be producing further output by using isoquant and isocost technique of production function. Then we will be doing those lessons in our upcoming classes. Thank you very much.